heirloom, and what we need from you is one thing that you're sentimental about.
Action figures.
Action figures.
Thank you. We collect G.I. Joes and we sell them for a shit ton of money on eBay.
You wouldn't believe what people put in the Goodwill. Perfectly good G.I. Joe figurines.
That's right, and we've got every single one. We've got the one with the beret.
The one with the commando hat.
The one with the machine gun.
The one where he was in disguise without a hat.
The other one with the machine gun.
Doug and I, we met in a comic store, and we were having an affair. It's been rejuvenating to meet someone in a comic store when you're 50 years old.
I'm having sex with her.
So scandalous.
Like, we've been in this plastic container for a long time. Please buy us.
I know we're special. We're not supposed to be open, but like, we just want to be played with, okay?
Yeah, she's great. She's a 1968. There's nothing like her. I swear, her dress is vintage. All the other ones sold out and they've already been ruined by now.
She's so clean.
She's so clean. I'm a little bit dusty, but I want to be loved. Won't someone buy us? Come on. I have these high heel shoes. They're a little bit ruby red. They're a little bit, I don't know, fake crystal. Won't someone buy us?
My mom says I'm not allowed to. You know, we have to, though. Come on. No, damn, stealing is wrong. Not if you don't get caught, it's pretty fucking awesome. Damn, we're free. Damn, remember when we tried to sneak into that bar? My mom knew. She knew. Somehow she knew.
Yeah, because you fucking told her. You told her. You like, Mom, I tried to sneak in a bar.
I can't keep it inside, okay? It really bothers me, you know? Doing bad stuff, it's bad. Dan, it's bad. Not in front of the school.
Smoke-free zones are an illusion, bro.
Teachers, you can get caught. I can get caught. I can be guilty by association, Dan.
You want one?
No, I do not want one, and you should not want one.
But I do. We could steal that action figure, too, if you... You know, stop this pussyfooting around.
No way. I've told you a million times, no way. It's not right, okay? That's somebody's figure.
Yeah, it's the store's figure.
Yeah, and he paid good money for it.
No, they didn't. That's the entire thing of the capitalist system, bro. They pay a little bit and they mark it up for us. Don't you understand that it's all a scam, man?
It doesn't seem like I do, but it still feels wrong.
I don't know if we can be friends anymore.
Yeah, I would strongly recommend that you put that out.
Or what?
Something bad's gonna happen, Dan!
Quill, you always worry too much, you know?
What's the worst that could happen? Cancer? Death? Getting caught? Jail? My mom beating my ass? Any of those!
Your mom beating your ass? You're 13 years old, bro. Come on.
It hurts!
Yeah, I'm telling you. It's out there. It's real. I saw it. I went down to the Goodwill, and I was just poking around in the men's suits like you do.
Cowboys don't exist!
They're real!
They're not real!
They're 100%. How do you explain
the
giant...
Have you seen a cowboy? You pretend he's just all man dressed as a cowboy.
Okay, so, no, but I've seen a lot of evidence. You know, I've seen lassos. Those who came up with lassos if cowboys aren't real?
That's believing in God for a while. God, the next thing you're going to say is Greenland. Greenland exists. Greenland doesn't exist.
I was gearing up to say that, yes, Greenland exists.
What the fuck?
Eric the Red, he like, it's like a whole country. You think a whole country doesn't exist?
Oh man, this is just, I can't believe it, bro.
That's where cowboys come from, it has to exist.
Pirates exist? Do pirates exist?
Pirates demonstrably exist. Have you seen the movie with the guy in Somalia? Who is it?
2 years younger than me. I just want some. There's some people who say in the jar that you're embryonic. You didn't grow. You did not grow. Do you like know everything's fake news? You have to filter out to what you're reading in a book.
All right. You know what?
You know it in your heart if something exists or don't. Doesn't.
We're both a little bit upset right now. I think maybe we should just calm down and finish getting ready for the bake sale. Just put this aside for now.
I mean, I love you, but I worry about you. You know, every time you say something like, you know, I don't know, like, polo exists as a sport.
Polo exists? What? Why do you think they call it the polo grounds?
All right, you two. Do I have to tear you apart from each other in the eye? They're canoodling again in my shop. Can you do something, intern?
What else are you gonna do in a comic book store, huh?
I canoodle. Guys,
please.
People are trying to read here, they're trying to buy products.
You mean they're looking at pictures?
Yeah, I mean, just like, keep it down, will ya? Can you just kinda like help them out a little bit?
If you guys could please just move it aside if you're not gonna...
Okay, I'm not buying this guy.
No,
I'm not buying this guy.
Look, we never get time together. We're in eighth grade, so like everywhere
we're
is a date
grade.
For us, okay?
We still live with our parents. I know it's embarrassing.
I don't mind any customers. We're really desperate for business here, but just keep it down. You're just a little bit loud. It's disturbing people, all right? Maybe like in the front of the store, it'll make it look like it's a little bit more popular in here. How about all three of you? This guy doesn't have a lot of friends. Why don't you join them?
You want a canoodling threesome with 2 8th graders?
No. Honestly, like, if you guys just want to hang out, just like hang out.
Because we're into it. I mean, it's 2018. We're very modern.
No, that's not what I'm saying at all. I just want you guys to be like a little bit more out in the open, a little bit quieter.
It seems like you want this stuff from us, but it seems like we're running the show because we're the customer.
Yeah, customer's always right every year and that. It's called capitalism.
Right. Well, capitalism works if you buy something. So if you guys want to purchase any of these magazines.
Oh, I have my mom's Apple Pay on the ready, so I can buy something anytime.
Oh, great. Well, I mean, if we can if you want to show them a couple of our books, are you guys interested in X-Men or...
I guess we can look at their books here in this comic book store.
Okay, great.
This is the latest in the X-Men series.
It's not sexy enough.
Guys, that's a lot of canoodling going on right now. Can you just bring them up a little bit? This is just like
No. I think we tell you what we want this store to be like.
Yeah.
I think we need like a seating area.
Yeah.
I think
a comfortable couch.
Do you want us to stay here or not?
I mean,
might buy something at any moment.
Well, all right. I mean, if you guys are going to buy something, we have a nice little stool you can sit on one at a time. Not share, sit on one at a time. No, come on, guys. This is normally his chair. He's giving it up for you guys.
Oh,
come on.
Yeah, remember, I don't buy him.
Are you guys going to buy anything today?
Maybe.
I mean...
I don't know about you, but I just love to snuggle.
I just love curling up next to someone or something I love.
Yeah, I think sex is overrated. I would just cuddle with someone. That's so much more fun, you know? So much warmer. I feel warmer inside.
Just like holding hands.
Oh, just bodies wrapping all on top of each other and then just lying there for hours.
Just rolling around, just rolling in a non-sexual manner. No, I just like to have someone over and just watch Netflix, you know?
Yes, me, best thing in the world is just fireplace, bearskin rug,
person or thing you love.
And I thrive on sweet nothings. Like you come very close and you're almost kissing, but you stop because there's a bee in the windowsill.
I don't even want to get close to kissing. I just want to like handshake, look each other in the eye. I just love it when the sweat starts to roll off of you because you're staring at each other so hard.
Just whispering erotic fan fiction together, just like friends do.
I don't like any of this!
You know, just watching Friends with a good friend, you know? It's great.
You know, just in complete silence on a hardwood floor with a person or object you really admire.
I collect like these fragments of silences in a tape recorder and play back to me in moments of quietness to listen to the sound of silence between the pauses of the words that I spoke or didn't speak with my significant other.
Really, all of the intimacy I want is just when you walk down a hallway and you get just close enough and you make eye contact with someone and you go. Just like the sound of the sheets as you start to pull them apart and then wrap them around yourself and say, I'm taking a nap.
Just getting completely naked in front of somebody you're not gonna see tomorrow.
Hey, you're a little bit of a bad boy. Is that right? Are you in 8th grade? 9th grade?
7.
It's fine. Well, look at the high school. Yeah, that's right. High school.
High school.
Yeah. You know, send me down here to do some recruiting.
I might be interested.
You know, we're just getting older, quite frankly.
Yeah. Burning.
15.
15.
And, we want to make sure that the legacy continues.
Want to smoke?
No thanks. I think.
I like that. It's new school.
Still addicted to non-carcinogenic. It's the wave of the future, man. The secret's a little retro, to be quite honest.
You know,
I don't know if you're high school material, McAllen.
Listen, I didn't come to you. You came to me.
What are you trying to do? You trying to turn the tables? You trying to turn the tables on this negotiation?
I think the tables have been turned. You over there vaping and I'm straight inhaling carcinogen.
Emphysema.
I mean, you know, whatever, it's fine.
Are you just sitting in the bleachers here in this empty gym?
I do own this place.
No regard to the Spirit Week decorations all over the place.
I'm gonna light them on fire later. Fuck homecoming. Shit.
Man, they told me this new generation was something to be reckoned with. Man, I'm just too old. I'm 15.
Students, what are you doing in the gym here? Hall monitor, you gotta get back to class.
Right? I'm just with my 9th grade mentor here.
Is that smoke I smell?
Yeah, I someone's smoking in the bathroom.
I would really check on that.
You know, you too. Keep smiling. Get right back at me.
Thanks. Did you fucking narc on me?
Look, I gotta say, it's pretty impressive. You got this whole school wrapped around your little finger.
I don't know.
I think you're exactly what we're looking for.
I don't know if you're what I'm looking for.
Are you gonna start your own gang?
Alright, now in this here town of Greenland.
I told you.
We got a lot of cattle. We got a lot of parrots. We got a lot of lassoing up to do. Are you two just visiting in town for this weekend?
Oh yeah, we definitely are. Right, honey? We're just...
How much money did you pay for the stunt, Doug? How much money did you pay for the stunt, Doug? Well, you know what? A couple of dollars for Craigslist. Hi, hi. John, it's nice to meet you. Do you want to lasso these things?
things are made out of cardboard, but they kind of look like
cow. Last taping, just such a...
It's a recreation, Dana! This is exactly what it used to be like, and still is in some parts of the world, but you said you didn't want to fly because planes shouldn't work scientifically.
Do you have to have my passport to a place called Greenland? Which doesn't exist, because I discovered my passport in the dryer yesterday, and it was tagged with weird country names.
You know, sometimes I like to pretend I'm running a little customs desk. Hello, do you have anything to declare? What's that? Nothing?
I'm really
business
sorry.
Or pleasure?
Oh, that's nice.
Do you want me to pull up my pirate costume now? I don't know if this is the better thing.
Come on, Dane. Have a little spirit. What? And even if it isn't real, what's the harm in pretending? Right? We all pretend sometimes. Can it be fun?
I believe in what is reality. I live truth is the best gift anybody can give to you.
So that's what I believe in.
I
have it.
Thanks. Is this a damn?
Go ahead, go ahead. I'll lasso some cows while you guys are talking.
Honey.
The money that I'm saving for to go to school, to go to plumbing school. It's gone because plumbing school exists. I know this. I looked it up.
Trade school, yes.
No one's on the other side of that argument.
I'm trying to respect you. I just use my fun money. You know, this is why we're just not actually in Greenland. We're just in neighboring town of Greenland, Alabama. We found a guy off Craigslist who's going to...
Well, he's involved in the little
system. Just change her clothes from the cowboy to a pirate, and maybe he's gonna play polo next.
All right. Pirates don't play polo, but
yeah, that's that is.
Well, he's a laser tag. What can we do you here for?
We only want to pay for one person. We'll share the pack and the gun ourselves.
These guys have been causing trouble everywhere.
Oh, you? Couldn't keep that part-time job at the comic book store. Larry's working at the laser tag place.
Larry's gonna be fired, and it's not even for money. It's just for credit.
One pack doesn't really work for two people.
Oh, we'll make.
I mean, physically, it fits over one body.
We basically are one body.
I mean, they are pretty cool, you know.
I'll get the equipment.
Look, I hate to be the one to bring this up, but we've encountered your intern before. We kind of frequent all the after-school hangout spots.
Yeah.
Bookstores, laser tag.
Convenience
store.
Stuff like that.
You guys have to get close to put the one vest on.
Right. She goes in front.
Arms, please. Arms.
Yeah. So you were complaining about the intern, yeah?
Yeah, he sucks. Look, I know that we're only in eighth grade, but kind of like the customer's always right.
Let me get this good and tight for you guys.
I mean, you're right. The customer is always right. That's literally why we're doing this, whatever this is.
This guy understands capitalism.
Mm-hmm. I don't dislike you, this intern.
Just hand me the groin strap.
He's very handsy, and we're only in eighth grade.
Somebody wants to get in this vest with us.
Mm-hmm. I mean, do you want him in the vest with you?
No. We're together.
Not the largest size. I wouldn't.
Okay. Go get it in here.
Be better.
He's gonna run your business into the ground.
Yeah.
We're trying to be best here, but I don't know.
It's kind of a vague mission.
This alone vest would allow me to be strapped together.
We already said no to a threesome with you before.
We haven't changed our minds.
I don't
What do you want?
What do you want? What's going on inside that noggin?
What do you want out of this internship?
Just here for summer to get credit.
You get credit for working in a laser tag?
Thank you for tuning in to Smooth Citizen Radio. That's right, CTZN Radio. Our topic today, the youth of the nation. We have a caller on line one who is just burning up to talk about it. Hello, caller. Thanks for calling in. What do you have to say about the youth of the nation?
I mean, the youth are terrible. You know? They really, on their YouTubes and their Venmos and their... It's just all a racket.
I'm going to stop you right there because I heard you say racket, and I'm afraid you're going to start talking about tennis, and I can't have that. We got another caller calling in from Huntsville, Alabama. Hey, caller, you wanted to talk to us about the youth of the nation today.
Yeah, I'm a youth, and I think we're fine. So, I've got Venmo, I've got the YouTubes, and I like tennis.
Okay, I'm going to stop right there. You had a strong point right up until the end, but I just can't get on board with the net and grass and or clay courts. We got a third caller calling in from Crystal City. Hello, caller. You want to share something about the youth of the nation and try to be a little bit more respectful this time?
Well, hey, I just want to say I appreciate your show so much. I listen every morning. I wake up, I fall asleep to your voice. Mm. It's just really my day. It's just like a ball being hit back and forth.
Okay, I'm going to stop. Folks, I feel like at some point I might have shared a vulnerability about myself. Funny. To target my show because I happen to have a certain sport I don't like. We're gonna take one more call about the youth of the nation and not a particular sport. Okay, this call's coming in from France. How lovely, an international listener. Caller, you wanted to speak about the youth of your nation, I guess?
Bonjour. Am I on the line?
Yes, you're live. Speaking to CTZN Radio right now.
Oh, fantastic! It's a pure pleasure to be talking with you. I'm such a huge fan, and I've agreed with all of your points. But all of the callers before you, they've made such an incredible points as well.
What would that happen to be?
Tennis back and forth, non-stop, all the action.
All right, thank you. All right, we're gonna go to commercial. Thank you all for tuning in. We'll be back in, I don't know, whenever I regain my composure.
Dan, this is an intervention.
You're doing an intervention all by yourself, bud?
No. I've gathered all of your friends and family. Yeah.
Yo.
Whoa. My mom knows everything you did. Everything.
Everything. And you're such a badass, Dan.
Thanks.
Love that teeth. Mm.
Real fucking cool, man.
Mm. Wait, what? No, that's not how you're supposed to tell them that this is bad.
It's.
Makes me blush.
Oh, you guys have turned just by looking at him?
No, we've been on his side the whole time.
Well, you said we were going to come hang out with them, so we were like, bring us in.
Yeah.
If interventions weren't so lame, we'd be having one for you, you know?
No, this is wrong. This, all the things you taught me, Mom, and you've destroyed people's lives.
Name one lie.
Sam, the guy who was in the competing gang, you killed him, Dan. In the face.
This was definitely a Dan job. He's so fucking cool.
I'm not saying I did or didn't kill.
I looked into his cold, dead eyes!
You carved your name into his chest.
Thank you!
Just so glad you did.
Can I just say... So, your husband has been playing lab mind games on you for 10 years?
Yes.
Mine too. Let's run it.
LA because murder is bigger than marriage.